This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to easily make your photos look like antique oil paintings. This is an update of tutorials I've done on the subject. This tutorial is quicker and more effective. Open a photo that you'd like to use for this project. In keeping with the theme of antiquity, the end result will look best if your photo doesn't include any images that could question its age. In other words, just don't include any modern objects or modern clothing. The filter setting amounts I'll be using in this tutorial are for images that have a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. To check your image's resolution, go to Image and Image Size. If it's not 150 pixels per inch, just type it in. The width and height will either decrease or increase, depending on whether you decreased or increased its resolution. Feel free to make its width and height any size you like. Make sure the chain link is active, so you'll only have to type into one of the fields to keep its aspect ratio intact. Open the texture I provided. Its link is in my video's description or project files. All antique oil paintings have a certain degree of surface cracks that appear over time. This fine pattern of dense cracking is known as cracular. We'll make the texture into a pattern, which we'll apply over our painting. Go to Edit and Define Pattern. Then, click OK or press Enter or Return. Open back your photo. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill the empty layer with the texture pattern, but before we do, we have to fill it with a color in order to fill it with the pattern. Check your foreground and background colors. If you press Alt or Option plus Delete, it'll fill with the foreground color. If you press Control or Command plus Delete, it'll fill with the background color. Double-click the top layer to open its layer style window. Click Pattern Overlay. If it fills with a pattern other than the cracular texture, open your list of patterns and scroll to the bottom. It'll be there. Just click it to fill your image. You can adjust the size of the cracks by scaling it down or up. I'll keep it at 100%. Right-click or secondary click on an empty area of the layer and click Rasterize Layer Style. This will allow us to change our texture's blend mode later. Hide the texture and make the photo active. We'll convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Let's zoom into our image so we can get a closer look at it. Press Z on your keyboard to open the zoom tool and drag it over a small area. To move your image within the screen, press and hold the space bar as you drag it. Go to Filter, Stylize, and Oil Paint. If your Photoshop version is CC 2014 or CC 2015, there's no oil paint filter. However, I did a tutorial showing how to find and install an oil paint plugin for free. This plugin is unfortunately not available for Macs. The link for the tutorial is in my video's description. If you do see the oil paint filter but it's grayed out, go to Image, Mode, and make sure RGB color is checked, as well as 8 bits per channel. If it's still grayed out, go to Edit, Preferences, and Performance. Make sure Use Graphics Processor is checked. Click Advanced Settings and make sure the top two are checked. In Macs, make sure Use Native Operating System GPU Acceleration is checked. I'm using these setting amounts, but feel free to experiment with them for your image. The stylization adjusts the style of the strokes, ranging from a smear look at 0 to smooth strokes at 10. I'll set it to 1. The cleanliness adjusts the length of the strokes, ranging from shortest and choppiest at 0 to longest and most fluid at 10. I'll set it to 5. The scale adjusts the relief or apparent thickness of the paint, moving from a thin coat at 0 to thick paint gobs at 10. I'll set it to 1. The bristle detail adjusts how much of the paintbrush hair indentation is apparent, moving from soft at 0 to leaving strong grooves at 10. I'll keep it at 10. The lighting angle adjusts the angle of the light, and the shine adjusts the brightness of the light source and the amount of bounce off the paint surface. I'll make it 0.5. Next, we'll sharpen the edges. Before we do, let's zoom back out by pressing Ctrl or Command and the minus key on our keyboard a few times. You could also press Ctrl or Command 0 to fit it back onto your screen. Go to Filter, Sharpen, and Unsharp Mask. Basically, Unsharp Mask sharpens by increasing contrast along the edges of an image. The amount determines how much to increase the contrast of pixels. I'll set it at 130%. The radius determines the number of pixels surrounding the edge pixels that affect the sharpening. I'll set it at 2 pixels. The threshold determines how different the sharpened pixels must be from the surrounding area before they're considered edge pixels. I'll keep it 0 levels. Make the crackular texture visible and active. Change the blend mode to multiply. You can choose to keep the texture's opacity at 100% or reduce it to your liking. Next, we'll brighten it and increase its contrast. Open the Adjustments panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Adjustments. Click the Levels icon. I'll make the input black level 12 and the input white level 233. Since each photo has its own characteristics of brightness and contrast, feel free to adjust these amounts. Lastly, we'll give it a slight warm color cast, which occurs often over time to oil paintings. Open the Adjustments panel again and click the Photo Filter icon. Open the list of filters and click Orange. I'll keep its default density 25% since this particular image is already relatively warm. Feel free to increase it if you like for your image. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.